This video is sponsored by Expo. If you're getting started with reactnative, this is how it usually goes. You create your app, which has a lot of simple elements and APIs, such as text, images, and scroll views. But as soon as you need something extra, like getting access to the calendar, the user contacts, or file system, you'll need to install native dependencies. To do so, you will usually need to work on a Mac for iOS applications using Xcode and Android Studio for Android. This can be very intimidating, especially if you're coming from React and have a web background where Objective-C and friends are probably not familiar to you. To solve this, Expo, which is a set of tools and services for React Native, has largely improved the developer experience. It would provide you with a list of native libraries that you can use right away without the need to install them yourself. On top of that, you could make an app from start to finish with any computer and phone in a very short time, which is what we're all looking for, right? Now, Expo had one key limitation, which was that you had to leave Expo if you ever needed a library that wasn't part of their list. And while you could think this is fine, I can continue without Expo, this often led to a bad experience given all the advantages there were to using it. Now, this is where things are changing today. The main question is, how can you stay with Expo tools and services no matter which native libraries you need? Well, here's the thing. What if you could continue using Expo if you want, but also add it to any React Native project? What if whenever you're limited by the libraries Expo offers you, you can create your own set, just the ones you need without all the complexity that comes with mobile development tools? This is what custom development clients give you, the best of both React Native and Expo worlds. This also means getting over-the-air updates, simple push notifications, cloud builds, app signing, and more, without compromising on the native libraries you need. So, how does it work? Instead of using the Expo Go app, which has a defined set of native libraries in it, you will start with a fresh React Native project that uses the Expo Dev Client package. This turns your development mode application into a similar experience to every Expo app. The difference now is that it comes clean and only with your current native code and libraries. This means that if you need another native library, you will need to recreate an app that contains this new package. It's as if you were creating a custom version of Expo Go for your project. If this looks scary to you, just know that Expo made this as simple as possible for everyone. If you have Android Studio or Xcode installed, you can do this locally using Expo Run Android or iOS. But if you don't or want a simpler way, you can run this in the cloud using Expo Application Services, EAS, that will send your local project over to Expo, generate your new app, and let you install the build on your device using a QR code. So if you were to add a native library, want to access Health Kit on iOS, for example, you would start with Expo install React Native Health, which will automatically add a dependency to your package.json and a plugin to your app.json, which is the file that defines your application using Expo. If you look into that file, you'll see a new field called plugins, which keeps track of every native library required for your project to run. Also, it gives you extra configuration for each plugin, setting the permission messages, adding resources files or properties to your app manifest, and more. Once it's done, just create a new version of your app that will not contain the native dependency. Again, you can do this on your computer or by using EAS, both will work. After it's created, you can use the native dependency directly in your app and have the rest of your team continue development in JavaScript only. This is a game changer because if you're using EAS for creating new clients, you won't ever need Xcode or Android Studio again, which makes development much closer to web developer experience. With this workflow, you'll now be able to add any native library supported by Expo Config plugins, which includes Bluetooth, payments, and most fancy React Native libraries out there. On top of creating app clients that are more like new runtimes for React Native apps, EAS also supports sending updates to your application and publishing it to the app stores, all with simple commands in your terminal. As always with Expo, you can get started with these services for free. If you've always wanted to get the best out of Expo without being limited by their list of libraries, be sure to check out their documentation about custom development clients. Thanks again to the Expo team for their great work and for letting me share all the good news with you guys. Thanks for watching and see you next time.